हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट अबाउट दी मल्टीपल इनहेरिटेंस। माय नेम इज शैलेश गवई। आई एम एन असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर एट डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस एंड डेटा साइंस फ्रॉम द कॉलेज AISSMS इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी पुणे इटसेल्फ। एज वी नो देर इज एम्बिग्यूटी बिटवीन some of the inheritance like multi-level, multiple and single inheritance. Today we will discuss about the multiple inheritance. Why it is introduced? Because we can find some ambiguity, some errors in single level inheritance. So the multi-level inheritance or multiple inheritance is introduced apart from single level inheritance. Let us take this example for our program creation or for the source code creation. We have already discussed about the single inheritance. Our today's topic is about multiple inheritance. Multiple inheritance has a feature of C++ where a class can inherit from more than one classes, or a child class is created from more than one base classes or parent classes. Why it is introduced? Because there is ambiguity in single level inheritance. If the base class and the derived class have functions with the same name, then only the members of the derived class are called through the object of the derived class. This is called the ambiguity in single level inheritance. If we want to call the members of the base class, then we use the special symbol, that is scope resolution operator. So here we are using scope resolution operator, but before going to use that operator, let us see the general syntax and the diagram of inheritance. A derived class can inherit the data members and the member functions from all its base classes. You can see in the diagram there are two base classes, B and C, for the child class in the same mode or each derivation in different mode. This implies that it can inherit privately from one class and publicly from another class and protected from some other class. To remove such type of ambiguity, we use again scope resolution operator. This is the general syntax of multiple inheritance. Subclass can inherit the base class 1 and base class 2 special characteristics as well as properties. Here, four-wheeler and car is created from the base class vehicle, or a vehicle and four-wheeler can create a car. So the OBJ is used for the object of a particular car. Class car can inherit the properties of vehicle as well as four-wheeler. We cannot use two-wheeler for child class car. I'll summarize with the help of multiple inheritance with syntax, source code and diagram of multiple inheritance. Reusability is one of the most important concept, and easily debug space required for the multiple inheritance is very less. Dynamic memory allocation and with the help of delete and new are the two variables we use for dynamic memory allocation, and such type of variables we use in all types of inheritance also. I have referred the books of E. Balaguru Swami and Rajesh K. Shukla for the references. Tutorials point is also we can use for our reference. थैंक यू सो मच फॉर पेशेंटली लिसनिंग दिस वीडियो.